So good morning students, in today's class we are going to see the DMA controller interfacing, that is of 8257. DMA controller is 8257 interfacing. Okay, so before going to the content, we will see the overall concept of DMA controller. Okay, so DMA controller, why we going for DMA controller is nothing but, okay, in case of using the same memory of 8086, while the 8086 is working under the multiprocessor condition, okay, there will be many disadvantages over there. Okay, so the first disadvantages is there is a chance of overflow. So overflow is in the case, so it needs to store more number of data according the availability of the capacity means it is very tough to store those data. So we need of some other memory location. So for that we are going for DMA. And another one is at every time the other processor wants to access the memory of your 8086 or the main processor's memory means it needs the access of the communication bus frequently. Okay, so to avoid these conditions, these situations, okay, the processor is working along with the DMA processor controller. So the controller, DMA controller, which is used to store the data, are acting as a memory for when the processor is working under multiprocessor condition. Okay, so this is the nothing but about the DMA controller. This is nothing but the DMA controller. Okay, and another thing, okay, there may be a question like whether we can interface only one processor with the DMA controller means it is not. Okay, so in this 8257 here, yeah, the four channels are available. Okay, so it can interface, the 8257 can interface with four processors. Okay, so in that four processor, one processor will act as a main processor and remaining things are coprocessors. Okay, so while accessing the bus of main processor, even though that 8257 is having the separate memory locations, oh, it is a memory allotment processor. Okay, your 8086, if the DMA also wants to access the common bus of 8086 means it wants to give the hold signal to your main processor. Once, so hold signal eppa kudukonona when it is working under minimum mode na onoda 8086 mattu onoda DMA kuda work pannadhu appadina na it is under minimum mode. Okay, so if the DMA is working under n number of processors means it is under maximum mode. Okay, so appa enak, if I want to access, the DMA wants to access the main bus of your 8086 processor means, okay, under minimum mode it should give the signal request pin in hold, HLD hold. Once it receives the acknowledgement back from the main processor, then the DMA can access the common communication bus. Okay, either the data bus or address bus. Okay, meanwhile, if it is working under maximum mode la work ahara nero, it should give the request pin in request or grant signal pin. Onoda 8086 la you are having a pin called a request, RQ/GT. Okay, that is nothing but the request or grant signal pin. Okay, so in case your main processor or DMA is working under maximum mode appadina onoda bus access ku request or grant pin la vande nee vande request kudukku. Okay, once it receives the grant signal, the DMA controller can access the bus. Okay, so evlo ner access pannala, at how much time it can access the bus means, okay, the DMA allotted the time cycles for accessing the bus. So if it allocates 10 cycles, means till 10 cycles the DMA controller can access the main communication bus. Okay, after that it left over from the main communication bus, the 8086 take over the access of the main communication bus. So this is nothing but the overall content of 8257 DMA controller. Okay, so okay, first we will see the signal pins of 8086, sorry, 8257. Okay, so we will see the pin diagram of 8257. Okay, so first pin and the second pin, you have already know about it, input output read pin and write pin. Okay, both are all in your low signal. Okay, so when it gets enabled means when it goes low, it these pins get enabled. Okay, so I want to give a note that, so whenever the DMA controller will act as a slave, all these pins, whatever pins present in this signal pins, are act as an input pin. Okay, then only it can able to get the data, input data from your main processor. Okay, whenever your 8257 controller, that is your DMA controller, will act as a slave, all these pins are work as an input pin. Whenever this 8257 controller will act as a master a irukrappo, so these pins will be act as an output pin. Okay, so it will give out the data to the slaves. Okay, so keep it in mind. So this is the very important point. Okay, so you want to mention these point in while explaining all the signals. Okay, so while it acts as a slave, this 8257 will act as a slave, the signal pins are act as an input pin. When it when the 8257 is as a master, the pins acts as an output pin. Okay, so why is it so? Because while in slave, it wants to get the data from the master. When it is of master, it gives data to the slaves. Okay, so why it is act as a, it is acting as an output pin. Okay, so input output read and write, memory read and memory write. Wherever you will have a bar above the above the word, so it represents that it will get enabled when it goes low. Okay, next one is mark. Okay, so mark means it is wherever it needs to end the data. Okay, that is nothing but mark. Ready, you have already studied about it, so it is ready to access. Okay, you have already studied these signals except mark. You have most of the signals we have studied in the previous unit, most of it in 8086 also. Okay, next one is hold, address store bit, address enable. Okay, so address enable pin is used to disable the system data bus and control bus driven by the CPU during DMA operation. So this is the function of address enable. Okay, so address enable, which is used to disable the system data bus and control bus driven by the CPU during DMA operation. Okay, next one is hold request. Hold request, I have already told about. Student, anybody is having
a screen visible illa pa,
okay. Appo students yaarume inform pannala
illa ma'am? Ujjwala message panninda ma'am, or student reply panninda, innor payangal message panninda, message panninda Preeti Chakravarthy.
students
Voice break for the ma'am.
I can't able to use the chat box. If you are reset, the answer is it visible or not?
Now it's visible, ma'am. Now only your voice is able to hear clearly, ma'am.
So visible are ka, sir? He said you are having the DMA acknowledgement 2, 3 in the 14th and 15th, 24 and 25. You will have the DMA acknowledgement pin off. Okay. So DMA acknowledgement, we are having 4 DMA acknowledgement pin. So why we are having 4? I'll let you use the acknowledgement, access acknowledgement via this pins. Okay. And another 4 is DMA request pin. That is of 16, 17, 18 and 19, and 20 is the ground pin. D0 to D7 is the data pin. A0 to A7 is the address pin. VCC is nothing but the supply. So this is about the signal pins. That is the pin diagram explanation. Okay. So we will see about the architecture now. So this is nothing but the architecture of 8257. So this is of architecture of 8257. So previously while explaining the pin diagram, I have told about the acknowledgement, DMA acknowledgement and request pins. Okay. So in that pin diagram itself, we have noticed that we will have 4 DMA acknowledgement pins and 4 DMA request pins. Okay. So far, that is why, because we will have 4 channels of, 4 channels are present in the DMA controller. Okay. So for each channel, you will have a separate acknowledgement and the access pin. So why we will have 4 pins in the signal description. Okay. So, so far I have already told you that the DMA can interconnected as act as a memory of for multiprocessor. So multiprocessor அப்படின்றப்ப நான் எத்தனை, so in the 8257 la how many processor I will get connected with this 8257 is we can connect with 4 processors. Okay, so 4 processors அப்படினா அது எங்க எனக்கு கனெக்ட் ஆகும் அப்படினா that is nothing but through this channel, channel 0 1 2 and 3. Okay, by using, make use of these 4 channels, okay, the other processors are get connected with this DMA. Okay, so the chip support this 8257 chip support 4 DMA channel at a time. Okay, so this is this 8257 controller is having 8 bit internal data bus. So this is of having 8 bit internal data bus. Okay, so in the data bus buffer itself, it is it's showing that above AD0 to D7. Okay, this resembles that of 8 bit internal data bus. Okay, so each channel 0 1 2 1 3, so all these channels, each channel will have two 16 bit registers. One is the DMA address register and another one is terminal counter register. Okay, so within the channel you will have two 16 bit registers. One is the DMA address register and another one is the terminal count register. Okay, so this is these two registers are having in each channel. Okay, so in common to that, other than these two registers, so you will have another two register which is common for this 8257. Excuse me. Students, is it audible?
Yes, ma'am, it's audible and visible, both of.
Okay, sir, thank you, sir. Okay, so other than these two individual registers, we will have a common register of 8257 is, one is mode set register and another one is status register. Okay. So totally we will have 10 registers in this 8257 DMA controller. Okay, if the CPU wants to select one of these 10 registers is through the pin called A0 to A3. Okay, with through this A0 to A3 pin, it will select this 8257 selects one of these 10 registers. Okay, so first we are going to see about the address register. So the address register is to store the address of the starting memory location accessed by DMA. Okay, so each one of the, you are having four channels separately, right? So each channel will get connected with some other processor. So for these channels, it is these channels will have the separate memory location for the access. அப்போ எனக்கு ஒரு பர்டிகுலர் சேனலுக்கு நான் ஒரு மெமரி லொகேஷன் அலாட் பண்ணிட்டேன் அப்படின்னா, செகண்ட் சேனல நான் அதே மெமரி லொகேஷன்ல அலாட் பண்ண முடியாது, அதுல நான் வேரியேஷன் பார்த்துக்கலாம். ஸோ அப்போ நான் அந்த பர்டிகுலர் மெமரி லொகேஷன்ல வச்சு நானு இந்த இந்த சேனல்ல நான் ஆக்சஸ் பண்றதுக்கு ரெக்வஸ்ட் கொடுக்கலாம். ஒரு பர்டிகுலர் சேனல்ல நான் ஆக்சஸ் பண்றதுக்கு நான் ரெக்வஸ்ட் கொடுக்கலாம். ஃபார் எக்ஸாம்பிள், சேனல் ஜீரோக்கு நான் வந்து 8000 கொடுக்குறேன் அப்படின்னா, சேனல் ஒன்னுக்கு ஐ கேன் கிவ் 2000 ஆர் எல்ஸ். Okay, according to the memory location, the particular channel will get accessed. Okay, so the address register, which is used to store the address of the starting memory location accessed by DMA. Okay, next we'll see about the terminal counter, that is represented in TC. Okay, terminal counter. Okay, terminal counter, which is used to start the data transfer after the required number of DMA cycle. So terminal counter அப்படின்றது வேற எதுவும் இல்ல. So actually now previously I have said that for a particular function the DMA needs n number of cycles அப்படினு சொல்லிட்டு சொல்லிருந்தேன். Okay, so n number of cycles அப்படினா எனக்கு அது finish ஆகிறது எனக்கு எப்ப தெரியும் அப்படினா, by use of this terminal counter. Okay, it will terminate the counts. Okay, counter anga actually in 8086 you have studied about the counter. Okay, counter abindrana for example string manipulation instructions adha vachila nama paakrappo n number of data kudukuren enakku oru particular loop vandu access aagudhu abindrana and the access edhu varaikku and loop vandu enakku execute aayite irukum till the counter will reach the value 0, like the same எனக்கு ஏதாவது டிஎம்ஏ எனக்கு அக்சஸ் பண்ணிக்கிட்டு இருக்குன்னா, வென் இட் கெட் டெர்மினேட்டட், வென் இட் access, when it gets the value 0, it gets terminated. Okay, so this terminal counter is initialized with the binary count of required DMA cycle of minus 1. Okay, so enakku evlo required a irukko adha vida minus 1 da vandu vachi initialize pannuvom. Okay, so after each DMA cycle, the terminal counter register content will be decremented by 1 and finally it becomes 0 after the required number of DMA cycles are over. So this is about the terminal counter. Next one is mode set register. So I have already told this mode set register and status register or the common register of 8257. Okay, previously we have studied about the, we have saw about the address register and the terminal counter register. These two registers are a 16-bit register which will be present in each channel. Okay, we are having four channels here. So in each channel, your address register and the terminal counter register will be get present. Okay, now we are going to see about the mode set register as well as the status register, which is common for 8257. Okay, so mode set register, which is used for programming 8257 as per the requirement of the system. Okay, however, we want your DMA to work, we want to use the mode set register. Okay, so the function of this mode set register is to enable the DMA channels individually and also to set the various modes of operation. Okay, so another one is the status register. So status register is also for the same purpose. Okay, status. Status is nothing but whether it is get enabled or disabled. We want to get the status of it. Okay, so status means what is the status while so and so cycle of the DMA execution. Okay, so it shows the status whether it is get enabled or disabled, whether it gets overflowed, whether you are having any request from some other processor like that. Those status will be get enabled in your status register. Okay, so these are the content which is present in your 8257 DMA controller. Okay, let me see the architecture, the blocks of the architecture. So in the left side, in the center of center, you are having a common bus of 8257. So 8257 in the bus access one only for 8257. It is the internal data bus, and in the left side you are having the data bus buffer. I have already seen in the previous architectures, and the read write logic. So these also I have already saw: input output read, input output write, clock reset. So A0 to A3. So A0 to A3, which is used to select one of the 10 registers. Okay, now already told you, students. Any doubt? Anybody is having doubt? Okay. So if I want to access any one of these 10 registers, I want to use the address pins through A0 to A3. Okay. And another one is chip select. We have already saw in the previous interfaces. So when it goes low, these particular DMA chip gets enabled, or else it will get disabled. Okay, so the remaining things are the when we go for control logic and mode set register. So in the first four is the address pins, and the ready pin is nothing but the particular processor is ready to access the bus, common bus. Okay, HRQ is nothing but hold request. HLDA is nothing but hold acknowledgement whenever. So previously I have told you that these two pins will get work when the processor is in minimum mode. Okay, so memory read and memory write, address enable, address store back. Okay, next one is the TC, terminal counter mark. I have explained previously. Okay, so as I've told that you are having four channels in your DMA controller, channel 0, 1, 2 and 3. So each will have its address register as well as the terminal counter register separately. So both the register is of 16-bit register. Okay, so this DRQ and DACK is nothing but the DMA request and DMA acknowledgement, which will get accessed by the other processor. So if a processor wants to access this DMA, this particular channel of DMA, means it wants to give the request to the particular channel. Okay, so if it gets free, எனக்கு இதுக்கு முன்னாடி ஏதாவது ஒரு ப்ராசஸா இன்டர்கனெக்ட் ஆயிருக்கு, இப்ப எனக்கு அது ரிலீவ் ஆயிட்டு அப்படின்னா, சோ இஃப் த டிஎம்ஏ த பர்டிகுலர் சேனல் ஆஃப் டிஎம்ஏ இஸ் கெட் ஃப்ரீ, இட் வில் சென்ட் பேக் த அக்னாலஜ்மெண்ட் டு த ப்ராசஸர் விச் கேவ் ரெக்வெஸ்ட். ஓகே, இன் கேஸ் இஃப் இட் இஸ் நாட் மீன்ஸ் இட் ஓன்ட் ரிப்ளை பேக். ஓகே, சோ திஸ் இஸ் த பர்பஸ் ஆஃப் டிஆர்கியூ அண்ட் டிஏ அக்னாலஜ்மெண்ட். ஓகே, ஈச் சேனல் இஸ் ஹேவிங் DRQ and D acknowledgement pin separately. Okay, so here you are having the priority resolver. Priority resolver is nothing but in case n number of processors or two or more number of processors will give the request at a time. So interrupt la nama paathame the same condition. Okay, in case two or more processor will give the request at the same time, means the priority resolver will solve the problem accordingly. So it gives the chance according to its priority. Okay, so this is the nothing but the priority resolver. So this is the architecture of 8257. Okay, so just I will recall it once again. So 8257. Okay, so before going to the revision, I want to say about the mode set register, and this is one is the terminal count condition. Okay, so mode set register, so it is of 8 bit. D0 to D7 is nothing but the register of mode set. Okay, so first one is the least significant bit D0 is the least significant bit, and D7 is the most significant bit. Okay, so if the D0 bit, that is the least significant bit, gets enable means nothing but it will get set. Actually here you want to make a note of one thing. Here you are having two types, one is set and another one is reset. Set is nothing but one, reset is nothing but zero. Okay, some of the pins will get enabled when it goes low. Okay, when it goes low, some of the pins will get enabled when it goes high. Okay, so on the low pins, how to identify the low pins? That is because of you will have a bar above the particular signals. Okay, input output mele bar irunduchi appadina adhu resemble pannaduna அந்த பர்டிகுலர் பின் ரீசெட் ஆனாதா, அதாவது லோ ஆனாதான், ஜீரோக்கு வந்தாதான் அந்த பர்டிகுலர் பின் வந்து எனேபிள் ஆகும். ஓகே, சோ ஒவ்வொரு பின்னுக்கும் ஒவ்வொரு கண்டிஷன் இருக்கு. ஓகே, சோ இஃப் த D0 bit get set னா இஃப் இட் கோஸ் வித் 1 மீன்ஸ் த சேனல் 0 will get enabled. லைக் த சேம் இஃப் த D1 பின் will get set, the channel 1 pin gets enabled. If D2 gets 1, if the channel 2 gets enabled. If D3 gets 0 means the channel, particular channel, the channel 3 will get disabled. Okay, like the same, if D4 pin will get 1, enable rotating priority. Priority is clear, so it will get the rotation process. That is 0, 1, 2, 3 is clear. அதுக்கு ப்ரையாரிட்டி வந்து எனக்கு ஜீரோக்கு ஹையஸ்ட் ப்ரையாரிட்டி இருந்துச்சுன்னா, தட் இஸ் த சேனல் ஜீரோ இஸ் ஹேவிங் த, இஃப் த சேனல் ஜீரோ இஸ் ஹேவிங் த ஹையஸ்ட் ப்ரையாரிட்டி, மீன்ஸ் சேனல் 3 வில் கெட் த லோவஸ்ட் ப்ரையாரிட்டி. ஸோ அந்த ரொட்டேஷன் பேசிஸ்ல உனக்கு அதை டிஸ்ட்ரிபியூட் பண்ணும். ஓகே, அண்ட் எக்ஸ்டெண்டட் ரைட், வென் D5 கெட் எனேபிள் மீன்ஸ் it enables the extender write operation. Okay, if D6th pin gets set na banna irundhuchu appadina, it enables the terminal counter start. Okay, and if D7 bit gets 1 means enables the auto load. Okay, so this is nothing but the mode set register. It is the mode set register. So this is the next one is the terminal count condition. So this is nothing but the terminal count condition. Okay, so it is also of 8 bit. The if the D0 pin will get set, it shows the terminal counter status of channel 0. Okay, if D1 gets 1 means it shows the terminal counter status of channel 1. Like the same for D2 and D3. If D2 gets 1, it shows the terminal counter status of channel 2. If D3 gets 1, it shows the terminal counter status channel of 3. Okay, so if the D4 pin, the D4 pin, sorry, the D4 register, the particular bit shows the updated flag register status. Okay, so each processor will have the flag register. So we have already studied about the flag register in 8086 also. Okay, so in D4, this is the particular bit which shows the update of the flag register. Okay, so the D5, D6 and D7, these are the don't care pins. Even though if it is of having 0 or having 1, it won't consider it. Okay, so this is about the terminal counter register. Okay, moreover, I want to say one thing. Ma'am, if you have 0 vandhirukku, 1 vandhirukku, idella okay. Idha vandha unnoda processor eppadi eduthukum appadina na, totally, ipo enakku appa enakku don't care, 01010 appadina irukkunu vechukoye. அதுக்கு ஈக்குவலன்ட் ஆன ஹெக்ஸாடெசிமல் வேல்யூ என்னது? ஃபார் எக்ஸாம்பிள், 00000001 அப்படின்னு இருந்துச்சுன்னா இட்ஸ் ஈக்குவலன்ட் ஹெக்ஸாடெசிமல் வேல்யூ இஸ் 01. ஓகே, ஸோ அப்போ இது பைனரியா உன்னோட இந்த கண்ட்ரோல் ரெஜிஸ்டர் செட் ஆர் ரீசெட்டை வச்சு அந்த பர்டிகுலர் பிட் வந்து அதோட வேலையை செய்யுது. அதுக்கு ஈக்குவலன்ட் ஆன ஹெக்ஸாடெசிமல் வேல்யூவை நீ ப்ரோக்ராம்ல கொடுக்குறப்போ இட் வில் டேக் அஸ் பைனரி அண்ட் இட் ப்ரொடியூஸ் தோஸ் பைனரி வேல்யூஸ் இன் திஸ் பர்டிகுலர் பிட் அண்ட் இட் வில் வர்க் அக்கார்டிங்லி. ஓகே, கேன் யூ ஏபிள் டு அண்டர்ஸ்டுட் ஸ்டூடெண்ட்ஸ், கேன் யூ ஏபிள் டு அண்டர்ஸ்டுட் ஆர் நாட்? ஸோ திஸ் இஸ் நத்திங் பட் த ஆர்கிடெக்சர் ஆஃப் 8257. I will once again briefly explain the architecture of 8257. So this is nothing but this chip will support 4 DMA channel at a time. Okay, so this 8257 will have 8-bit internal data bus. So each channel will have 2 16-bit register. One is the DMA address register and another one is the terminal count register. So first one is other than this two register, this two register, we will have two common register called mode set register and status register. Okay, if the CPU is nothing but your 8086, so we have studied all the interfacing according with your main processor as 8086 processor. So why I am mentioning as 8086? ஓகேவா, சோ இந்த சிபியூ மென்ஷன் பண்ணிருக்கிறது உன்னோட 8086 ப்ராசஸர் தான். ஓகே, தென் த சிபியூ செலக்ட் ஒன் ஆஃப் தீஸ் ரெஜிஸ்டர் மீன்ஸ் இட் வாண்ட்ஸ் டு அக்சஸ் த்ரூ A0 டு A3 பின். ஓகே, A0 டு அட்ரஸ் பின், A0 டு A3. ஸோ வை ஆர் தீஸ் 4 பின்ஸ்? இட் த சிபியூ வாண்ட்ஸ் டு செலக்ட் த அபவுட் 10 ரெஜிஸ்டர், எனி ஒன் ஆஃப் த அபவுட் 10 ரெஜிஸ்டர். ஓகே, so we just going to see about the address register. So address register, which is used to store the address of the starting memory location, which is accessed by the DMA. okay, next one is the terminal counter. Terminal counter is used to stop the data transfer after the required number of DMA cycles. Okay, so the terminal counter is initialized with the binary count of required DMA cycle of -1. After each DMA cycle, the terminal counter register content will be decremented by 1. And finally, it becomes 0 after the required number of DMA cycles get over. Okay. Next, we will see about the mode set register. Mode set register, which is used for programming 8257 as the required requirement of the system. As per the requirement of the system. So mode set register is used for programming 8257.
Hello, ma'am. Ma'am.
Requirement. Okay. So its function is your channel. Particular channel is get free or not, or it is accessed by some other processor or not. Okay. Sir, is it audible, sir? Any doubt, sir?
No, it's
is
clear.
Is it audible, sir?
Yes, ma'am. Yes,
sir, is it audible?
Yes, ma'am. It's audible.
Sir, is it audible, sir?
Yes, ma'am. It's sir? Audible.
Okay, okay.
Sir. Take it, ma'am.
Okay, sir. Thank you, sir. Thank you, sir. So, this is about the status.